which one of the following rational numbers has terminating decimal expansion? So the first option is 11 by 7000. So terminating means a number, suppose if it is p by q a number, the denominator should have the factors of 2 or 5 or 2 and 5. So other than 2 and 5 we should not have any other number, then it is terminating. We should have 2 or 5 or 2 and 5. Now we'll check here 7000. So prime factors of 7000, if you do 2 times 3500, 2 times 1750, 2 times 875. Next here now 5 times 175, 5 times 7. So here this is 11 by 2 cube into 5 cube into 7. So when you have something extra, check whether is there any chance of cancellation. 7 and 11 will not get cancelled. So it is non-terminating. Non-terminating. Okay, now next one, 91 by 21,000. So for 21,000, if you do prime factors, so 2 times 10500, 2 times 5250, 2 times 2625, 5 times 525, 5 times 105, and next 5 times 21, 3 times 7. So 91 by 2 cube into 5 cube into 3 into 7. So here check, this 3 and 7 is extra. Check, is there any chance of cancellation? 7 times 1, 7 times 13. But we have this 3 extra here. We should have only 2 and 5, then it is terminating. We have 3 extra, therefore it is non-terminating. Non-terminating. We want terminating decimal. So now here this 343 by 2 cube into 5 cube into 7 cube is 7 times 7 times 7, that is 7 times 7 49, 49 into 7 is 343. So 343 and 343 cancel. So you're left with 1 by 2 cube into 5 cube. In the denominator, you have 2 cube and 5 cube, so therefore it is terminating. It is terminating decimal, so the correct option is C. Once we'll check for this 9000 also. 9000. So 9000, if we'll do prime factors, 2 times 4500, 2 times 2250, 2 times 1125, 3 times 375, 3 times 125, 5 times 25, and 5 times 5. 5 times 5. So here 21 by 2 cube into 3 square into 5 cube. So 21 by 2 cube into 3 into 3 into 5 cube. 3 times 1, 3 times 7. See, we have one more extra 3. We should have only 2 and 5. We have 3, therefore it is non-terminating. So the correct option is C. If A root C, A root C equals root AC, then which of the following condition is like true? So here, see, if we'll do squaring on both sides, if we'll do squaring on both sides, A root C whole square, AC whole square, root AC whole square. So here you'll get A square C, because square root cancel. Here square root cancel, AC. C and C, 1A, 1A, so A equals 1. So the correct option is A. Or orally also you can do like a root c equals root ac. In place of a, if we'll substitute 1 by trial and error by taking the options, so root c equals root c. So the correct option is a equals 1. LCM of two numbers is 108 and HCF is 9. LCM is 108 and HCF is 9. One number I'll take it as A, 54. So we need to find the second number. So here we have the formula, that is LCM into HCF equals product of two numbers. LCM is 108, HCF is 9, one number is 54, we need to find the other number B. So 108 into 9, if we'll transpose this 54 equals B. 54 times 1, 54 times 2, 2 times 9, 18. So therefore the other number is 18. The correct option is B. If X and Y are two prime numbers, then their HCF is. See, if I'll take two prime numbers, X and Y. So X I'll take some prime number 5 and Y I'll take 7. So the HCF of 5 and 7, see, you can do 5, you can write as 5 times 1, 7 you can write as 7 times 1. So HCF is 1. So the correct option is B. If you'll do by like division method, 7, 5, 5 times 1, 5, 2, 5, 2 times 2, 4, 1, 1 times 2 is 2. So here the HCF is 1. So if two numbers are prime, then their HCF is 1. The correct option is B. If A, the prime factors of A are given 2 cube into 3, the prime factors of B are 2 into 3 into 5, and the prime factors of C is 3 power n into 5. And they give the LCM of all the three numbers like A, B, C is 2 cube into 3 square into 5. So see, LCM will select by taking all the numbers, but when they are common, we'll select the highest one. For example, 2 we have here and here. Here we have 2 power 1, here we have 2 power 3. So we'll select the highest one, 2 power 3. This is prime factorization method. Now here we have 3 common in all the 3 numbers, but we'll select the highest one. So already they selected 3 power 2. Here we have 1, here we have 1. So here in place of n, definitely it should be 2. So the value of n is 2. I'll give an example. Suppose if a equals 2 cube into 5 square into 7, b equals 7, or otherwise take 2 power 4 into 5 power 1 into 11. So here LCM will be, in this 2 we'll select the highest one, 2 power 4. In this 2 also we'll select the highest one, 5 square. In this we'll write 7 and 11. So here already they got 3 square. So here it is 1, here it is 1. So definitely this n value should be 2. So the correct option is B.